Apple. Really? What is all this crap I have to attach to my computer? Look at it. What were you thinking? And the Canon EOS M6 with the flip-up screen. Today is going to be a video on exactly how I make videos from the road. What equipment I use, why I choose to use it, my thoughts and reviews on it, and my recommendations for you. Let's get started. So this is a video I get asked to make a lot. People want to know how I make my content on the road, what I use to make that content, and what I recommend. So I figured it is time to do the video. I've got myself a nice hotel room here, which isn't always the case. Keep in mind, a lot of this equipment throughout this review, I do use alongside the road, camping, next to my bike, in rural situations. I have to be able to capture this content and deliver it online from anywhere in the world. I'd like to start by saying there is some equipment here that I typically use that I do not have with me because, well, I screwed up. That's right, I did have a Mavic Pro drone, which I think is a great product, but I ran it into a power cord and crashed it, and it's broke, and it's currently at DJI getting repaired. Fortunately, that is no longer part of my arsenal, and I am not using a drone. So you'll notice I have a lot of power cords. This, in my opinion, is the biggest struggle when on the road traveling making footage, because batteries run dead and you have to find places to charge them in. I have sat at gas stations, coffee shops, restaurant, anywhere I can find a place to find outlets and just start plugging in to keep all of this alive. My computer. It's a 2017 MacBook Pro 15-inch. It's a great computer for editing on, but I don't recommend it. If I had to do it all over again, I would have bought the 2016 model before they changed it. See, the new Apple laptop only comes with the C USB port, both sides, and one audio jack. That's it. No USB, no HDMI. Nothing like that. In order to connect your devices, you need these things. They're called dongles. Plug them in the C-USB and they adapt to whatever you need, whether it be USB, whether it be HDMI, another C-USB, so you can go C-USB to C-USB, and you can create this chain of just garbage. I don't know if this is a ploy, Apple, to sell more products, but I've had to buy more of these, and these things are not cheap. Anywhere from $35 to $80 a piece. This one goes to a monitor. No way to do it on my new Apple, so I had to go buy a $50 piece just to put my image up on the screen. This is a really neat one. This one I do like. It uses two C-USB ports. It's called the HyperDrive, and on the other end, it gives you your card readers. It gives you more C-USB ports, because Lord knows we don't have enough C-USB ports. It gives you two USB ports, which are really the thing that I use a lot. Storage. I use the Lacy hard drives. They're an impact resistant, they're good for traveling on the road, and they're very durable. But always, always keep two of them, because these things do crash. And when they crash, you'll lose everything you have. There are places you can send them and pray. Pray, pray, pray that you get your footage back. But I always have a backup. So I have a backup, and I also send one to a friend who backs up other places. So I keep mine backed up in two places. The Lacy hard drives are very good. This one's, I believe, a 2 terabyte, and this one here, 4 terabytes. So you can get them in different sizes. And I definitely recommend them. GoPro. I use the Hero Session 5. It's a good camera. One, it's got image stability, so it stabilizes your image. So when you're on a motorcycle, that is a big factor. Two, it's small, it's inconspicuous, it's not this huge big camera. I do have a GoPro Hero 4, but I never use it, so I figured this wouldn't be a good place to show it. I always go to this session. It's very nice, it charges quick. You plug it in, you can charge it with a USB. So I actually just charge this little joker right on my bike. This is also a waterproof camera, so I can ride in the rain. I can go in the water. I will tell you one thing, you will get better imaging off this GoPro if you attach it to your helmet. There's a lot less vibration on your helmet. There's separation between you and the bike. When you attach it right to the bike, you do get a little bit more vibration. My main camera, as I showed you before, is the EOS M6. I did have the Canon G7X Mark II. It was a really great camera, but the lens is motorized and it goes in and out with motors, and it was just a lot of moving parts for the rugged type of living I do on the road. Lastly, I do use a Joby Pod. The Joby Pod is great for when you wanna hold the camera up and you wanna have that good wide range selfie. You can attach it to just about anything you want. I use it a lot on the fairing of my bike to shoot back and get me loading scooter in and out of the bike. It's great for just setting it on the ground and driving past the camera. These things are really, really good. I will say get the heavy duty one. These ones are like 80 bucks, but it's worth it. I've had the cheap ones and the balls end up separating from this rubber piece right here and the arms start coming off and you run the risk of dropping or losing your camera. Audio is another question a lot of people ask me about, and really I just use the audio on the camera. I really would like to step up my audio game and start using mics, but it's just more stuff to carry, and when you're on a motorcycle, the limited space is a big deal. SD cards, storage. You are going to need storage. You got to store your footage. These are the SD card. It's a Pelican case that I use for holding all my SD cards. It's waterproof, it keeps them safe. Waterproof and dustproof is a big deal when you're living on the road. I fit almost all of it in this soft case. It's actually repurposed out of army tents. It was given to me by my friend Sally. And this really carries almost all of this equipment. It goes right into my saddlebag locks. I'm nice and safe going down the road. Simplifying, you can overdo it. And what I've found is when you overdo it, you just have too many cameras running, you've got too much footage out there, and then you end up having a hard time using it all. And sometimes it becomes such a mountain that it's just like, it becomes so overwhelming, sometimes it's hard to even get started on editing it, going through it, and getting it up on the internet for everybody to see. You all are looking at me on a tripod. This helps me get that stable shot, steady shot, so it's not killing all of your eyes to look at it. There you have it. This is my daily vlog setup. This is what I use. You asked for it. You wanted to know. There's the information. I hope it helps you make some decisions on getting out and filming your next adventure and sharing it online and exactly what equipment you can use for that. If you found any of this useful, guys, if you support what we do out here, go ahead and smash that thumbs up button down there if you're into that kind of thing. And if you have not, please consider hitting that subscribe button. We will continue to work hard to earn your subscription. Hope you all have a great day. Till the next video, we'll see you later.